Hello, guys and dolls. I'm doing a webcam. It's yucky, I know, but it uploads faster, and the live stream stuff, I've just given up on it totally for right now. So anyway, welcome to day 6 of 30 days selling online. Today is report card day for me. And before we get to that, I have some questions that I want to answer live here. And again, as I always promise, I'm going to try to keep it short, but y'all know me, I just yammer. Hopefully y'all are getting good information from my yammer. If not, leave it in the comments below. Ready? Okay, here we go. Let me get some questions going. These were all on eBay, by the way. Okay, number one, let's go to Nice to You Too Picker Ohio says, this was on the day 5 video. Thanks for explaining more about new stuff for Amazon. Really am weak in knowledge about Amazon. I did get my first check from my first item. Thanks again. Number one, congratulations. How did that feel getting a little extra jingle in your pocket? I know you probably worked very hard for it, but whatever you've learned so far, that knocks off your learning curve on the next one. So way to go. Very awesome. And yes, with Amazon, it's just one of those things. You just, you know, learn as you go. It's kind of like with eBay. You just learn as you go. So thank you for the comment. Thank you for the watch. Not like the watch, but like the watch. And nice to you too, Picker Ohio. You've always been a very consistent viewer and commenter, so I appreciate that. Thank you very much. And I hope you're enjoying the series. I think that you are. Obviously, that was on day 5, so let me know. Okay, the next one. Oops! I went to the wrong place. Let me try this again. Okay, Joyce Newton says, and this was on... Okay, this is on one of my videos that has the highest views. The name of the video is eBay Power Seller Gives Away Tips. And this was the question or comment or whatever that Joyce Newton put on there. It says, I have never sold online, and these were great ideas. Thank you very much. I look forward to listening to more ideas and then trying it out. I hope you have a video about how to estimate shipping and organizing items before shipping and all of that sort of thing. Thanks. Number one, you're welcome. Number two, yes, Miss Joyce, I have lots and lots of videos. If you go to my, and this is for anybody, if you go to my channel page, all you have to do is just click on my name, Wesley GW, on any of my videos. That'll take you to my channel page. If you look down that, you will see what are called playlists, and there's one on there called Selling Online, and there are several, several hours worth of videos on there, all kinds of information. So that kind of covers a thing about wanting to listen, you know, and try new ideas out. Hope I have a video about how to estimate shipping and organizing items before shipping. Okay, estimating shipping, I'll just tell you right now, and if y'all want me to do a more lengthy video on this, leave it in the comments below so I know that y'all want information. Estimating shipping, of course, number one, if you do flat rate shipping via the United States Postal Service, you get free boxes and you know how much your shipping's going to be anywhere in the continental United States. And if you choose to do international, there's also flat rate international shipping. So there's that pretty easily. Other than that, with regard to estimate of shipping, honestly, you will get to the point where, or I have gotten to the point where I can put something in my hand and I can go, okay, that's going to be about 3 ounces, believe it or not. Another thing that you can do is to get one of those postal meter scales. You can get just the regular non-electronic ones at office, you know, office supply places. You can probably find one at a garage sale or a moving sale, or unfortunately, a bankruptcy of a business will probably have one. And then that way, at least when you're listing something, like if you want to list it by the weight, all you have to do is put a box with the item in it that you'd probably ship and just throw some tissue on top of it, kind of calculate the shipping, add an ounce or two if you feel like it, and then that would be a good estimate there. Also, organizing items before shipping. I'm not quite sure what that is, Miss Joyce. So if you're watching this, can you give me some more detail on that one below? Because I don't really know how to address that one. But anyway, thank you very much. And as I always say to people, thank you very much for watching and thank you very much for your comment. Okay, the next one that I've got is, let's see, this is from Snapper 761, and this was on the day 2 video. This is so sweet. I am glued to your videos to the very end. This is so very, very new to me. Retired 6/28/13. Oh, so you're like brand new, newly retired, like 2 weeks. Need to do this from scratch, from taking pictures to shipping. By the way, love your style and your son is just great. Thank you so much. Well, I think he's pretty great too, so thanks for noticing. But yes, congratulations on your retirement. That's awesome. Don't know if I'll ever get to that point, but hey, here's hoping, right? Thank you for watching. Thank you for the comment if I'm glued to your videos to the very end. I do get concerned sometimes that y'all will not watch to the end because when I get done with the video and I try to compress it, it's like, this is still 20 minutes long. There's no way they're going to watch this, but I guess the people who need the information will watch it. I'm wondering if my son is vlog bombing me in the background about right now. He may be, but that's okay. That's who my son is. We all love him, right?
I did that about 45 seconds ago.
Were you vlog bombing me? I'm trying to be all serious here to everybody, and my son is vlog bombing me. So.
You aren't a serious person, so it doesn't even
matter. Well, this is a true story. I don't know how often I'm ever serious. But anyway, let's seriously move on. But Snapper761, thank you so much. And again, you know, since I have free videos, if you want to go to my channel page, which means click on Wesley GW on any of my videos, you'll see it just right under the video. Click that, it'll take you to my channel page, and then scroll down and you'll see the one that says selling online. If you just click the word selling online, it'll start playing the entire playlist. So there you go. There was another one, I think. Okay, this was a long one. Okay, I hope not to tease, but this actually, let me make a note of it while I'm reading it. This one is from Tyler A. And Tyler A, I'm going to have to probably spend a whole video for you. So let me write down Tyler A video Q answer. I'll know what that means. But anyway, let me read it to y'all so you know that that will be coming up in a video probably this next week. This was sent just to my regular inbox, so it wasn't on a video specifically. It says, thank you so much. Since I have been on eBay for less than 30 days, I've sold 5 items. Awesome! And have made about $60 profit. That's good too. I know it's not much. Hey, it's a lot for right now. But I'm very excited that I actually sold something and made some money. I have recently listed more items, and I am waiting to see what happens. Currently, I am on YouTube waiting. Oh, waiting for day 4. Okay, so you must have done this right when I was hadn't uploaded yet, because it says to be uploaded, and I thought, hang on just a minute. Hey, dude, lower the volume a little bit. Well, they're like getting double sound here. Anyway. Currently, I'm on YouTube waiting for day 4, 30 days selling online to be uploaded, and I thought that I would send you a message. Earlier, I watched one of your videos, and you said if you're selling on eBay, you can get a lot more sales if you ship internationally, which is true. For more items sold, for more items sold, I'm willing to do that, but I have never done it, and I don't want to do it if it's a big hassle. So do you think it's more of a hassle to sell internationally? The next question that I have is about shipping large items. I know that you don't ship large items regularly, but I was wondering if you have some information about how to go about it. For instance, I have this bike I would like to sell on eBay, but shipping it, if it sells, seems very hard and expensive. Furthermore, I soon will be running out of things I want to sell from my home. Yeah. And I recently watched a video about buying things from Goodwill and then reselling them on eBay. Is this a good idea? Do you do it? How do I go about doing it? And then it says, I know you're a very busy person replying to people's messages, being a single mom and making videos, but I would appreciate it if you could reply to this message and answer my questions because I am stumped about shipping that bike. Thanks in advance. Well, you're welcome in advance, Tyler. And I tell you what, that's a lot of questions. And so as I was reading that, everybody, if you were asking the same thing, put it in the comments below and said, yes, I want to know the questions, the answers to Tyler's question or whatever. And Tyler, I will be doing a video on this, but I'll let everybody know when it's coming up. I'm going to say probably this next week of week two of that. So, because that's a lot of questions and they're all very, very good questions. And the only reason why I'm not doing it right now, Tyler, is because I'm trying to compress information for the time that we have. Okay, so Tyler's question will be coming up this week. Now, let me back up to day one, all the way back. I don't think I covered it very well where I got my numbers from and what I'm shooting for and etc. So let me try to clarify that, okay? There are, let's see. Okay. Working Monday through Friday is my goal. Working 3 hours a day is my goal. The goal for the month is $2,500 net. Okay. Now, where did I get that number from? I got that number from, it was a government website, QuickFacts.us/gov. Or .gov, I think. One of those, I'm sorry. I can't remember. Anyway, government website. Just Google it. It'll come up. And I typed in, what is the average annual income in the U.S.? And then, I'm trying to read my notes here. Okay, it was the per capita amount. And this is in the U.S. So, the number that they gave was $27,915 is the average annual income per capita in the U.S. Now that's per capita, not necessarily who's working, okay? But that's the number that I went off of. And then if you divide that by 12, that is $2,326.25, okay? And that's where I got the $2,500 net. Now, how can you know the difference between net and gross? And I kind of made the little joke about this on, I think it was Monday. Okay, you've got all your income that comes in as a business owner. And then you go, ooh, that's gross. I don't want all that money. Okay, that's all the money that you get before you take out taxes and expenses. That's the way you can remember it. Gross money is, ew, I have to get rid of this via taxes and fees and overhead. Okay, what you catch in your net after you've paid all those taxes, net, that's what's left. That's what you get, okay? So that's where I based my $2,500 a month on. Now, if I want that to be my net, right, I averaged back in about 30% for taxes and fees. That total, so in other words, $2,500 plus 30% is $3,250, okay, per month. That averages to, and this is a different number than I said on Monday because I did it without the fees. So that averages to $812.50 per week gross that I need to make, okay? So net, that's around, it's going to be over $600. Somebody do the math for me and put it below. In other words, take 30% off of $812.50. Okay, but based on that number, $812.50, that means on average, if I did $40 per sale, that could be 20 listings per week because 40, no, is that right? 40 times 20? Yeah, that's right. If I did $40 per sale, that would be 20 listings a week, okay? Now, if I did four times, you know, so in other words, 4 weeks in the month, that's going to be 320 listings per month, all right? So, no, that's not right. What am I getting wrong? 2, 4, 6, 8. That's 800. I don't know where my number is. I'm sorry. That's getting messed up. Anyway, but based off of that, $40 per sale, 20 listings per week, that would be 246, 80 listings per month. So if you did 80 listings per month times 40, that's going to give you about the numbers that we talked about. Okay, that's a number to shoot for. Let's say you only want to make $500 a month. Okay, so you're going to do $500 plus 30% of that. So it would be, you know, you do 500 times, and this is a trick, you do 500 times 1.30, that will give you your additional 30%. If you wanted to make, you know, $700 a month, it would be 700 times 1.3%, or just 1.3 equals, okay? If you want to know what that math means, ask me otherwise, trust me. But based on that, you know, that's where I got my numbers from. So hopefully that made it as clear as mud for y'all to understand what that was. All right, so now we get down to the nitty-gritty. We get down to the report card time for this last week. Now, if you've been following and if you watched the whole, you know, the whole time from Monday till today, you know that it has been, we had 4th of July and I got lazy. We had crazy, oh my gosh, you should have been here at this house, crazy day on, was it Tuesday? It was either Tuesday or Wednesday when the gremlins just took over my Google and my YouTube and my webcam and everything. It was just, it was horrible. Oh, and eBay got taken over that day too. So I really didn't get much done. All right. And two, I was kind of, I'll be honest with y'all, I was getting kind of flustered on, you know, what should I do? What should I do? So I was getting all caught up in that instead of just thinking about the content. So I got over all that. And then I had one, what I call is 100% successful day. All right. So this week so far on Amazon, I listed 56 items, one sold. That leaves me 55 items left on Amazon. Right now, there's about a $300 potential profit on the stuff on Amazon. On eBay, I listed two items. One of them will sell next week when the auction ends. And it's right now at $25. But regardless of that, that means I have two things on eBay, and it's about a $50 potential profit on that one. And then on Craigslist, I listed 11 lots. I have an inquiry on one of them, but again, I'm still going to say that I have 11 lots, and of those lots, it's about a $320 potential on that one. So all told, I have 67 items or lots listed at the end of week one for a potential of $660, and that only averages to $10 per sale. And if you remember the numbers I just said, it needs to be $40 per sale. So if you have less than the $40 per sale, like I do on this, then I need to be listing more, and listing 67 items in a five-day week is not going to cut it. So total hours I put in on everything was only 6 hours. So for the hours I put in, it's pretty much equal results. Y'all can see that. So I did no sourcing this week at all. That means I didn't go anywhere to buy anything. Everything was done with listing, with inventory, registering, and with, you know, packing and shipping and taking stuff to the post office. So for this week, I want you to leave it in the comments below right now what grade you would give me, an A, B, C, D, or F. And so go ahead and write that below, and I will show you what grade I think I should give myself. Did you hear me at all? What grade would you give me?
C.
You'd give me a C? That's generous. Okay. Did everybody put their grade in? Okay, so this is the grade.
It's no longer a grade anymore.
Well, it is in my world.
No, it's A, B, C, or F.
I give myself a big, fat, stinking D. So what do you, is that the right direction? I hope that's the right direction. So what do y'all give me? What grade do you give me? Leave it in the comments below. Next week, it will be better. I will do 3 hours every day. At least I may actually have to crank up to four, or I may have to work an extra day next week, which would mean Saturday. But there you go. That's the rundown of the end of week one. And tomorrow, which is Sunday, I will only be answering a question for you guys and dolls, and it will be how much do you make, or can you make? And in light of that one, we've come to the end of another too long video. And questions, comments, share, like, thumbs up, Twitter it, Facebook it, LinkedIn it, you know, everybody else. So on that, I'm going to get off so y'all can go have a good evening. Have a delicious, delightful, delirious day, and I will see you tomorrow.